election that I came out to? This is bad. Okay, this side cares. Everyone else is like, fuck that, you were right there. Good shit. Fantastic. I always like asking people this question. It's one of my favorite things to ask people before I start a show is, did anyone in here have a really, really, really bad nickname in high school? Then raise your hand and put it up in the air, and I'll ask you about it. No? No, not any of these weird people back here that want to look at people's asses, not the ass people? No. All right, fine. Apparently everyone here was on the varsity squad in high school and gave out nicknames to kids like me. That's fine. So, oh, you haven't heard the joke yet. There's a part to be that long. No, I went to Mars Area High School, class of 2003. That's right, right around here. Yeah, no one gives a shit. That's good. We're going to start there. Class of 2003, home of the Fighting Planets, HP, which stood for Fatty Fatty Hamburger Patty. Yeah. You win one fictional hamburger eating contest, you just never live it down. He ate 40 hamburgers before anyone realized he wasn't competing against anyone. Yeah, sad times, sad times. No, man, I don't know, this is a weird problem that I have, and it's pretty, I think, unique to me. Me and my mom have the exact same birthday. Obviously, we weren't born in the same year. We had the same birthday, October 16th, which is like a weird thing, right? Does anyone, no one else has that problem, right? Basically, this is a really fun way of me trying to say to each and every one of you is that I ruined my mother's birthday for the first 16 years of my life. Because every year it was like, oh, Derek wants a He-Man birthday. Okay. Oh, wow. Derek wants a Ghostbusters birthday. Okay. Oh, wow. Derek's 15 years old. He wants another Ghostbusters birthday. That's fucking weird. But then something terrible happened in my point of view when I turned sweet 16. Oh, sweet 16. That should be a good one, right? No, my mom turned 40. You know what happened? No one remembered it was my birthday. You want to mess with a 16-year-old kid? Forget his birthday. That's right. No car, no presents, no cake, no hand job from my high school crush, Jen Melodia. Nothing. By the way, sidebar, I got to stop saying that lady's name because she did go to my high school. And her husband is a Marine. He'll kick my ass. So I got to really stop saying that. But no. Instead, I got a hand job from Mars Area High School's class of 2003, most likely to fall through a lawn chair, me. And I didn't even do a good job. It was like a punishment one. It was atrocious. But no, instead, my mother, she had this lavish surprise birthday party at the Harmony Inn. And if you're familiar with the place, its two claims to fame are one, they have tacos above the Mason-Dixon line, and two, it's haunted, which is a pretty good marketing strategy as far as I'm concerned. But anyway, just the entire birthday, I get sat in the back and just be like, it's fucking bullshit. So anyway, flash forward, 4 months. We're going to the Barnes & Noble. We're going to go buy something for some other inane, stupid thing. And my parents are talking about this birthday party they had. And there's this great big thing. And I'm sitting in the back of the car. And I'm just like, this is fucking bullshit. I don't know if you've ever been in a sedan before. By the way, I know all of you have because there's a bunch of white people in here. So you love sedans. It's fine. And I'm sitting in the back going, this is fucking bullshit. So you hear everything I'm saying. My mom turns around. She's like, Derek, you had a good birthday, didn't you? You had a good birthday. And I'm like, okay, so I'm gonna lay it on thick now. And I'm like, no, Ma! Oh, what was my birthday day? And my mom's like, oh no, my baby boy. And she goes to go back and give me a little squeeze around the knee, to reconnect with me. And my stepdad just slaps away her hand while he's driving the car. He's like, Denise, you take your hand off that piece of shit back there. Let me tell you this, that kid had a great birthday, didn't you, Derek? Because we got you that up. Shit. I don't know, you want some Dungeons and Dragons books or something? I'm like, yes, Papa, that would please me so. So that's what I got for my sweet 16, everybody. I got Dungeons and Dragons books. So, I got laid a lot in high school. Slayed an awful lot of dragons. No, that's terrible. And this theory would apply to each and every one of you, no matter, everyone here is probably over the age of 21. This is what he believed. He believed that everyone over the age of 21 at one point, you have shit your pants. That's a weird thing to think about, right? That's not normal. That's not a thing that people like to sit around and like really enjoy. That's a weird thing, right? Why would you think about that? But people were sitting around this table, we've been drinking for a while, and he's getting everybody to tell their pants shit in the story. and it's like, it's getting around the table and it's getting close to me, and I don't have a champagne story. I have all kinds of crazy stories. I have a story about punching a fucking police horse. I have a story about getting hit in the ball with a swing set. Like, I have all kinds of crazy stories. For the life of me, I don't have a story about shit in my pants, and for a brief moment, I thought about lying about it to fit in. Which is weird, right? That's not normal. Like, I'm gonna lie about crap in my pants so I feel that I belong to a community. That's weird. That's so fucking weird. And so it gets to me and I'm like, I'm gonna be honest with you, I've never crapped my pants ever. And he's like, all right, well, I guess you're the 9th out of 10th doctor, you know, you're that guy. And then at that moment I coughed. And I shit my pants. Because like my body's like, this is hilarious, but this is the worst part of it. Since it's happened one time, that one time, it's happened like 6 other times. Like, which is terrible, it's just like compound interest. I don't know how compound interest works, it just seems like it sounds like it fits there. But this is the thing, by far the worst one was one morning I walked out of my house on the way to work, slipped on my sidewalk because it was crazy slippy out, slipped, fell down, shit my pants. That's called a Pittsburgh airbag, by the way, for those of you who are curious. Oh, that was not good. Not good at all. Oh, man. Here's another fun question for the audience. You can yell if you like this. Anyone here like Italian ice people in the house? What? Greetings for life. Get that tattooed on my arm I never did it. That's crazy. Never mind. That's fucking nuts. No, I love Italian ice. It's like someone took a bunch of Kool-Aid and was like, what if? It's like sugar water with aspirations. Oh, so good. So good. So good. And so, one day, me and my girlfriend, we go get delicious Rita's Italian ice. I got myself a gelato, which is like custard and Swedish fish water. It's so good. So good. So me and my girlfriend, we both get one, and we sit down, and there's this woman lying behind us just as we sit down. And the way I would describe her, if you guys are familiar with the Magic School Bus, there's this woman who drives the Magic School Bus. Her name's Miss Frizzle. Imagine if Miss Frizzle took that school bus instead of driving it into like an aquarium or like drove it across the universe or like through a water filtration plant. Instead, she took that bus and she drove it through every single scene in the television show Breaking Bad. Just like life fucked this lady over hard. Like hair's all askew, her makeup's kind of fucked up, way too old, and she has these two kids in tow. And I don't know where she got them from. I don't know idea where they came from. They're like clad in soccer gear. There's these weird kids. And they walk up to the counter, this one woman's just like, hi, I would like the two smallest Italian ices you have. What's the smallest size? And the girl behind the counter is like, well, we have a child size, that's pretty small. And she's like, no, I saw a smaller size earlier. And the guy's like, do you mean the dog bowl? And she's like, yes, I'll have two of those. And the guy's like, all right. So he hands her two dog bowls of Italian ice, no spoon, and just hands them to the kids. They're just standing there like, what the fuck is this? And the woman's like, and for myself, I will have two of the largest size you have in red. And the guy's like, do you mean Swedish fish? She's like, no, in red. So these kids, they sit down on the bench, and they're just holding these bowls, they have no idea what the fuck to do with them, and she's standing there with these two buckets of diabetes water, and just standing there having the best time of her goddamn life, like she's a Kennywood for herself, I don't know what the hell this is, and this one kid's just not having this anymore, he's just like, hey! 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 Why did you get two? And that woman gets up off the bench. And she gets down real low in that kid's face, and she has this big, real big smile on her face. And she goes, because I'm hungry like the wolf, Daniel! Listen, I know that was fucking weird, but that's also really what I saw. That's a real thing. And listen, I know we're all kinds of different people. I know we come from all kinds of different demographics. And we're a nation that's divided in many, many ways. I don't care if you're going to vote for Donald Trump. I don't care if you're going to vote for a toaster filled with mayonnaise. I don't care if you do prescription drugs or you do cool drugs like me. I don't care. There's one thing that we as Americans, we can all agree on right now. And that is you do not yell Duran Duran lyrics in children's faces. You don't. It's messed up. Kids can be messed up for years. Think about when he hears that track 12 years from now, he's gonna know a fucking sugar bender for a year. It'd be weird. But the best part of this wasn't that this woman yelled this in this kid's face, it was how the kid responded. He goes, "Hey, my name's Kevin." And the woman's like, "Get him back that Italian ice." Those kids are like, "No, you go to hell." And they laughed it up. But what I'm really trying to tell each and every one of you, including you guys who can stare at my butts, thank you, is that I really think what I really saw was a child abduction. So, pretty sure that they stole those kids. So, if you know many missing kids, they're probably the best magic school bus ride of their entire life right now. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Yeah, shit's crazy, yo. No, I love drinking. I drink for one very classic reason. It broadens your horizons, right? I learn things when I drink. I see the world in a new, beautiful perspective. And there's no better way to do that than to be blackout, time-traveling drunk, right? You know the kind of drunk I'm talking about? The kind of drunk where you go out and several hours later you appear somewhere else with different friends, different clothes, and less cigarettes? Yeah. That kind of drinking. All right, one guy has an alcohol abuse problem. That's fine. No, but one of the greatest lessons I ever learned in my life I'd like to share with you now, I learned while time-traveling to a Taco Bell. And as I rolled into the mist of time with me and my fellow time-traveling scientists, we'll call them, I walked in and I pulled out a sweaty $20 bill because all my $20 bills are sweaty. And I slammed it down under the counter and I said, "Hey, lady, give me a shitload of tacos." And the lady behind the counter, did something that absolutely blew my fucking mind. She did this. Boop. Not boop, 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 boop. Or beep, 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 boop. No, which meant at that West Mifflin Taco Bell, there was a shitload of tacos. Here in front of us was the greatest answer to the greatest philosophical question of my generation. How much is a shitload? And this lady named Shaquanda knows. So of course, I asked for the height of my intelligence and I go, "You got a shitload button, what?" And she looked back at us like we're a bunch of complete blithering drunken idiots, because we were. And she looks me straight in the eye and she goes, "Cha, everyone knows a shitload is 8. And we said, "Oh," because O is the sound you make when you learn something. And that's what we learned that day, everybody. We learned that a shitload was 8. So, yeah, sound, blah, blah, blah. And the next day, we learned that a beggar's shitload was 9. So, it was a pretty good time. It was a pretty good time. Okay. Good. Maybe you guys have just seen my DVDs. That's what this is. That's good. No, I will leave you guys with this story. I will leave you guys with this. I used to work for this terrible, terrible corporate hellhole. And one day I walked into work, my boss, she approaches me. Right before we're supposed to have this big meeting, she goes, "Hey Derek, I need to talk to you about the company dress code." And I'm like, "Is it because I'm dressing too sexy?" She's like, "Kinda." And I'm like, "What?" She's like, "Well, Derek, whenever you stand at your desk, sometimes you like to stretch out, and your gut ever so slightly hangs out of your shirt, much like a fat baby." In this story, I was not wearing an undershirt, so it was just, you know, my front ass hanging out. And let me tell you, if you want to be insulted or broken at work, have your boss call you a fat baby. Mind you, this was a 400-pound Latino woman who, when she wore polo shirts to work, she wore them with a little Tasmanian devil symbol right there. Not a little horse or an alligator where it's supposed to be there, a little Tasmanian devil. So anyway, so I walk into this big meeting, and I'm sitting there, and all my coworkers are sitting there from my department, we're all sitting there, we all have these manila folders sitting there in front of us, and I'm like, "Fuck it." And I open the folder, and it says, "Notice of termination from this company due to gross incompetence. Failure to attend work events." And at the very bottom, and very clearly scribed in at the end, says, "Failure to obey company dress code." And I immediately look up at this thing, and I look at my boss, I'm like, "Wait a minute, am I getting shit canned?" And everyone starts opening their folders all at once, and he starts screaming. This guy time, he's like, no! No! It was supposed to be a surprise! Which was terrible. But the best part of it was that there was a bunch of dudes in on a conference call. They're like, wait a minute, we don't have vanilla folders. Are we getting shit canned? And they're like, yes. Yes, Gary, you're getting shit canned too. Everyone's getting shit canned. Anyway, flash forward a year and a half, okay? Year and a half later, I'm messed up out of my mind. I'm like, I gotta get a new job. So I go and I apply to this new job. I walk in, the lady's like, wow, Derek, you're really good at this. You're very handsome. You're super qualified for this. It's like an awesome job. I'm tons of fringe benefits. It's like hand jobs on Fridays. Crazy job. It's like, Derek, the only thing I need you to do now is I need you to take a drug test. And I remember that moment very vividly. Because at that moment, an alarm went off to my head to the word fuck. And it went like this. Maybe you could get somebody's urine. And I'm like, yes. So, I did the worst thing I possibly could. I went to a comedy open mic. And this is like, most of you have never bared the horrible hell that is a comedy open mic. And I went in and I went right to the first guy I could find, which was New Guy. This is like, there's a lot of weird figures you deal with in a comedy open mic. And I walk up to New Guy and I say, hey, I don't know how to ask this to you, but can I have some of your urine? And he gave me a response that I did not expect. He went, yeah, absolutely. Do you want it now? Where do you want it? You want it in your hand? I'm like, no, man. Go back to my house and pee in a mason jar, I guess. I don't know. I've never done this before either. So he goes back to my house and pees in a mason jar. And then I got some advice from a nurse friend of mine. And I hatch my plan the next morning. I wake up. It's like 98 degrees outside. I'm like sweating bullets. The one thing he keeps telling you over and over again, you have to get this urine up to temperature. So that morning, I take the urine, pour an unlubricated condom, tie it off so it looks like some kind of weird P-dong, and it was just terrible looking. Take it, and then I remember what my boss said to me a year and a half before, and I stuck it under my baby fat, tucked it into my shirt, no one can tell. Just a weird, sweaty fat man, like normal. And then I put a little razor blade in my pocket, and just I get on the bus, and I'm just sitting there, and I really realize there's a flaw in this plan, and that is this. I am making a gentle sloshing noise wherever I go. And so I'm riding on the bus downtown, and I'm just going, just like some kind of weird pea marsupial just up in here. And this woman at one point, she gathers her two kids who are sitting across me close together. She's like, you stay away from that fat man. He's broke. So anyway, I get downtown. I walk into Quest Diagnostic. The moment they open, I'm sweating bullets. It's 100 fucking degrees outside. This thing, I have a heat wrap around it. I'm trying to get up the temperature. I'm freaking out. I walk in. The lady's clearly telling I'm freaking out. She's like, she comes around. She gives me a back rub. She's like, baby boy, you're going to beat this test. You're gonna get this, you're gonna get this new dick. You're gonna go to the next job. No one's gonna call you a fat baby. I'm like, how do you know about that? That's fucked up. And she pushes me into the bathroom. Second I'm in there, it's like game face, like bow, 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 bow. She looked at the side and she goes, wait a minute, that's weird. Huh. And I'm like, what? She's like, no, don't worry about it. I'll just pour another cup. Sometimes this happens. And I'm like, what? Oh my God, was that new guy? Was that new guy doing trucker crank? That son of a bitch! And another alarm starts going on my head at this point to the word fuck, and it's like a submarine diving. It's like, fuck! Fuck! And I'm freaking out. And she pours it in another glass. She twists the lid. She shakes it. She looks at me. She shakes it. She looks at me. She shakes it. And she looks at me. And then she puts down the cup, she takes off her gloves, and she says, honey, I don't know how to tell you this. This is the hottest goddamn piss I've ever seen in my entire life. It's 114 degrees. Yeah. I don't know how you did that. I don't know how you baked it that way. I don't know how you did that. You seem like a really sweaty dude, so I'm not gonna say nothing. You have a nice day. So I got a new job. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Derek Minto. You guys have been lovely. Have a good night.